Buccaneers, welcome back to another episode of Look Who's Quarantine. Today, we're going to show you Turing Tumble, a new type of game where you build mechanical computers powered by marbles to solve logic puzzles. You learn coding by using bits, gears, screws, and interceptors. If you like what you see, you can purchase this product in the link in the description. So this game is for ages 8 and up. You can play it with a single player or with multiple people. And inside, we'll show you in a bit. This game has won numerous awards, including the Dice Tower Seal of Excellence. And on the back, they list the contents of everything, and also they show you how this thing works. So step one is choose a puzzle. Step two is plan your approach. Step three is build a computer. And step four is start the computer.
This box is big.
Okay, it's time to unbox the game.
There's the board.
This is the board. It's kind of like a pachinko board. Pachinko is a Japanese pinball machine where you just like press the lever down and a ball will shoot out and come down the track. So this reminds me somewhat of it. This is, there we go. Okay, there's two sticks here. We can come back to this. This is, the green ones are ramps. The orange ones are crossovers. The bits are the blue ones. I don't know what those are. And there's an interceptor, which is the black thing. Where's the black thing? The black thing is in here. Yeah, the interceptor. Okay. Oh, here. Oh, okay, these are the gears and gear bits. So I guess these are what maybe rotate the ball. Okay, and here is the puzzle book.
And comic book.
Oh, that's because the back has artwork. That's Japanese anime. So I guess if that thing's like Japanese pinball machine, pachinko, and this is Japanese anime, there's kind of a Japanese theme. Okay, here's the puzzle book. Oh yeah, there is comics inside. Oh, there's assembly instructions. And then after all this, and the comic. Okay, how to play. Number one, each challenge has an objective. You must create a machine that completes the objective. To start the machine, you must press the start button down once. Oh, that was number two. Number three, once the machine is in motion, you cannot touch the machine or otherwise interfere with its operation. Number four, your machine cannot let balls drop freely for any distance. The ball cannot just drop down. It has to slowly make its way down. That's what it means. Okay. Number five, challenges start easy, but they become exceedingly difficult, even for a seasoned deep space telecommunications engineer. If you get stuck, take a break and come back to the puzzle later. Okay. All right, and then this is challenge one, starting from here. Okay, apparently in the beginning it's easy, and then the farther it goes, the harder it goes. Oh, puzzle solutions are on the back. It goes all the way to challenge. Okay, the last challenge is 60, so there's 60 challenges. All right, on each challenge, there's gonna be a number of stars in the right-hand corner. And that's the difficulty. The most difficult one, which is number 60, has how many stars? 7 stars. And the first one only has a half a star. Now we're going to assemble the machine and we'll show you some puzzles. We finished assembling the mechanical computer. So it took us about 10 minutes. And then there's a storage. I like how all the bits and gears fit neatly inside. We finished setting up challenge one. It's called Gravity, and the difficulty is half a star out of seven. The required output is for the 8 blue balls to reach the bottom, but only the blue balls, not the red. We started off with 6 in the setup, and there's 4 more that we need to figure out where to put. But before we do that, I'm going to show you how this thing runs if we didn't have the correct challenge, and just give you a general idea. Okay, so it did exactly what the objective goal was. However, one of the rules in the rule book says that it's not allowed to just drop down, which means that when it came here and here and here, it wasn't supposed to just drop down like that. It's not allowed to. It has to follow a ramp with no steep drops. All right, now we're gonna solve it. So we have 4 to work with. So this is gonna come down here, and this is gonna come down here. Then this is gonna come down here, and it's gonna drop. So we need something somewhere here. Okay, then this comes down here. All right, another problem here. Wait. All right, so now it's gonna come down like this.
Oh, please.
And the last one, it cannot drop, so. We're gonna press the push to start button.
I will.
This is fast. There's 8 balls here with no red. All right, time for challenge 2, called re-entry. It's also, the difficulty is half a star out of 7. It's the same objective, to have 8 balls at the end, but no red balls. And this time, instead of 4, there's 5 available green ramps to use. We're going to press the start button for challenge 2. Okay, this is challenge 5. It's called Entropy, and the difficulty is 1 star out of 7. The objective this time is to get blue, red, blue, red, blue, red, blue, red, and so on and so forth. A new element is introduced in this puzzle, which is the crossover. And what the crossover is if a red ball came from this side, it's gonna cross over to this side. And the blue ball that comes here is gonna cross over to this side. So they cross over, kinda like making an X. Basically, it has to end up at the crossover. So maybe like that, this and then this, so that it can cross over and do its thing to come down. All right, and then red. Okay, then blue. We're going to play some more off camera, and we'll come back with our final thoughts. So we've just played Turing Tumble some more, and in addition to the ramp and the crossover that we mentioned, there's 4 more aspects of the game. One of them is the bit, which means that when a marble comes down and it meets the bit, it'll go either left or right, and it'll alternate from going left and right. There's also the gear and gear bit, which flip each other, and the interceptor, which stops the marble computer from running. We've solved some official puzzles from the rule book, but we also like doing freestyle play, which is when we just make our own maze, and it's fun because you can experiment with the marble computer and make your own patterns. Overall, I think Turing Tumble is a very fun and educational game because you can watch the marbles run down your own computer, and you can even learn coding from building a marble maze.
My favorite part is building the marble maze and watching the marbles go down.
You can purchase Turing Tumble in the link in the description. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye!